Alright, what we have here is the Boxwave slide-out keyboard for a iPhone 4. It's my buddy's, he just got in the mail today. Show him how to put it in. Get it in, son. Alright, turn it on.
And as you can see, it slides out mint. Text one of my buddies. Help if it's turned on.
Okay, turn it on first. There we go.
I gotta get used to this.
Slides very easy.
Spring assisted.
Spring assisted, very nice. Downfalls are, keyboard does not light up, which isn't that big of an issue. If you wanted to text with your normal thing, it knows there's a keyboard on it, so you can't. The normal iPhone keyboard doesn't pop up unless it's turned off. Or, show them the other way to do it. By pressing the buttons. You gotta press
this button right here.
That button. And it shuts it off so you can use your normal keyboard. The only other downfall that we see with it right now is, well, one, it doesn't have a numeric keyboard unless you use the shift thing on it, the little blue thing, that function button. But it's very top heavy. It wants to kind of tilt, so you got to keep, a couple fingers on it. Other than that, it works very smooth, real nice. It couldn't slide any easier than that. It's a little wide, but not too bad. Camera's really recessed in there. As for width, I think it's just a hair wider. Granted, I got a case on mine. This is a Droid 3, comparing it to, which is kind of why he went for the Boxwave. The difference is, keyboards are very similar. Obviously, the Droid 3 is a hair bigger. Space bar's pretty similar, everything's pretty good. The Droid 3 does have a full keyboard, but, makes the iPhone very nice to use now. And that would be the Boxwave Buddy Case slide-out keyboard. Bye-bye.